Crystal asks 80 students at her school if they have a dog. She discovers that more boys have dogs than girls. Complete a possible two-way table for the situation. Notice how from the first row we know she asked 40 boys. From the second row, we know she asked 40 girls, and of these 40, 24 have a dog. And the last row is for the totals, and we know 80 students were asked if they had a pet dog. Let's focus on this row here first. If we know she asked 40 girls if they have a pet dog, and 24 said they do have a dog, we can determine how many girls did not have a dog by determining the difference of 40 and 24, because we know these two numbers must add to 40. Well, 40 minus 24 is equal to 16, which means of the 40 girls that were surveyed, 16 did not have a dog, and 24 did. Again, 24 plus 16 must equal 40, which it does. Now let's focus on the boys. We know 40 boys were asked if they have a dog or not, and we also know more boys have dogs than girls. So this number here must be more than 24. It doesn't matter what it is as long as it's more than 24, but not more than 40. Let's just say 30 boys said they had a dog, and that way that means 10 boys did not have a dog, because we know that 30 plus this number here must equal 40, and 30 plus 10 does equal 40. And now to complete the table, we just need to find the totals at the bottom, where this total would be the number of boys and girls that have a dog, and this total would be the number of boys and girls that do not have a dog. Well, 30 plus 24 is equal to 54, and 10 plus 16 is equal to 26, and notice how this works out perfectly, because 54 plus 26 does equal the total students that were surveyed, which is 80. I hope you found this helpful.